Hello, Internet! Welcome back to Let's Play Mega Man 7. Now, we just beat both Burst Man and Cloud Man, so let's go to the next stage, Junk Man. If you paid attention to the opening, you see that that foot that appears stepping on the floor in the opening sequence is actually Junk Man's foot. Junk Man's foot. It's pretty cool. I think it's a cool little nod to the fact that it is actually one of the robot masters that are in that little cutscene. It's pretty cool. I like what they did with this stage and the whole thing with the electricity. You see when you get there, but there are a few things you can do with the Thunderstrike, the weapon I just got. And also there's a thing you can get with the freeze cracker in this stage. You can actually freeze this molten... I think it's molten steel, probably, because it's a junkyard. And if you see down there, there's a staircase. You can actually go there if you freeze the steel. And if you do that, you can actually... go there, and down there there's the third letter of Rush's name, the H, no, the S in Rush's name. So... And here's Rush Jet, good old Rush Jet. I love this about this game. Oh, one extra life. Cool. That's super useful. I really needed that. Man, I love this soundtrack. It's so good. Oh, crap! Come on. Now I gotta get back from here. Oh, man. I don't know why I didn't make that jump. Like, it's not a very hard jump to make. Ooh, it is a good thing that I'm getting all these bolts. So I'm gonna do something pretty cool later. Okay, here we go. Stop right there and climb up the stairs. See, if we don't activate that electric thing, that thing doesn't go away from there, and you can get the rush jet. Now, speaking of, oh no, wait, it's still not necessary now. I can still just do this. Now I can do this. No! Oh, come on! I got stuck in the ceiling! I love this game. I still love this game! I died in a very stupid way, but I still love this game. Seriously. So much fun. Oh my god, this soundtrack, this music is amazing. Can't stress enough how good the soundtrack of the Mega Man franchise is. Like, seriously, it's just amazing. Ooh, another extra life! See, I recovered one life from all the ones I lost from being being stupid. Now we're gonna do it, Trash. Come on. There we go. No getting stuck in the ceiling, Trash. Just recover a little bit of the Thunder Strike. Oh, there's no problem in me getting here with low health. Like, Junkman's another pushover. This pattern is so easy. He's almost as bad as Cloudman. Okay. Except when he does that. Now his pattern is almost as exploitable as Cloudman. Like, really, like, see, he's a pushover. In case you're wondering, I'm also drinking coffee, because I love coffee. Oh, look at that. Auto again. A cool thing is that here they talk about the a few things, like, for example, Auto at some point will talk about that big boat he has in his head, that if you find it, he'll give you a discount on his items, because he has a shop. We're gonna visit his shop after I beat the stage, after I beat Freezeman. This is a pretty cool design. Like, I really like this boss. Yeah, don't slip. Yeah, it's an ice level, of course. And of course, it has ice physics. Oh, I did it! Speedrun strats! Speedrun strats! I was never able to do that. That was pretty cool. That was pretty cool, I gotta say. That was awesome. Jumping straight from that ledge to the stairs. That was cool. That was cool. I gotta say, that was pretty cool. If I say so myself. See, if you pay attention, it's always like they put you in the situations where you eventually have to learn something, but you have some time to learn it and adapt to the situation. You know, this game doesn't have any cheap deaths or anything like that. Like, if you die, it's your fault. You messed up. So there is the H, the last letter of Rush's name, and we're gonna get it. Now that we've got that, we can go down here. Find another Sniper Joe. And an extra life, thank you, Sniper Joe. I mean, look at the backgrounds in these stages. I mean, my god! Look at that! This game is freaking beautiful! let's go. Okay, there we go. I mean, my god, I freaking love this game. Oh yeah, by the way, that rush thing I got was the rush search. It's useful to find it's useful for finding a few items scattered around the some stages. Okay, now this is one of the bosses that don't have the reset the pattern when they're hit with their weakness, so I'm gonna take some damage here, probably. Oh my god, look at the lag! There we go. Told you I was gonna take some damage. Oh, it's Toto again. You get freeze cracker. This weapon's pretty good. It shoots in kind of six directions, and when it hits a wall it spreads, breaks and spreads into other pieces. And now a story cutscene. Pretty much what happened in this, what Dr. Light's telling Mega Man in this cutscene is that the people in this city, they have a museum where they keep the old robot masters from the other classic games, you know, the older games. Yeah, they keep them in a museum. So now, Wily invaded the museum trying to get one of them. Why he doesn't get why he doesn't take like all of them, it's beyond me, but okay. So as you can see here, there back there is Plant Man, Snake Man, Blizzard Man. That guy that I never remember. I really don't remember. Flame Man? Yeah, I think it's Flame. Yeah, it's Flame Man. Now Feral Man, Hitman, and back then another copy of Plant Man. I don't know why, but there it is. And here, what Dr. Wily was after, Gutsman, because everybody loves Gutsman. And back there you can see Skullman and Ringman. That's what I like about this game, it has so many cool references and Easter eggs. Now we have Clown Man's fat cousin. And in case you're wondering, I can make fat jokes because I'm fat. Go. When I started playing this game, my god, I was so bad at it. I could not beat this boss the first time I played it when I was a kid. Like, seriously, this boss was so hard for me when I was a kid. Now it's just a boss. So now what happens is pretty much Dr. Light tells me that there are now four more Robot Masters to deal with, and here they are: Slash Man, Spring Man, Turbo Man, and Shade Man. So now we're gonna go back. We're gonna go to Auto's shop, because I almost forgot to do this. There's an item we can try. I'm going to try to get here, which is which lets you escape. There we go. Oh, come on, I don't have enough money. Enough boats. Yeah, I gotta find beach first. Yeah, just... No. Ow. This is funny. So, I can't actually buy the item I wanted, so you're gonna have to sit through the whole thing of the whole Junkman stage, so sorry about that. Oh, come on, really? Remember what I said? You can actually freeze the steel, the molten metal, and you find a secret passageway with the S letter. And with that, you get that really cool rush upgrade. That's the thing I really like about the classic Mega Man games: the fact that rush exists. You know. Super adapter. Yeah, got another extra life. That's good too. The only problem with this upgrade is that you can't slide while you're equipped with it. You can slide to, you know, you can't. So now I'm going to have to unequip the super adapter to just slide through that gap. Besides, that upgrade looks super cool. So, there you have it. That's the part 2 of Let's Play Mega Man 7. See you next time, guys.